Hello, I'm Jeremy Boyd. I'm the host of The Bachelor, and I'm here with our first contestant. So why don't you tell us who you are and what you're about?
Well, I'm Elizabeth Morales. I'm a junior here at DePauw, and I'm 20.
Okay. What's your major? Do you have any interesting hobbies you want to tell the audience?
Well, I'm a psychology and Spanish double major, art history minor, and I'm a cheerleader.
I've been cheering since middle school, and I'm a flyer. So I'm the one that they throw up in the air, like I just go up and up and up, and they just put me up there really high.
What exactly are you looking for in a bachelor candidate?
For a bachelor, I just want someone like really strong, like really muscular, probably like your typical all-American boy, like very confident, like maybe want to join the cheer team with us, you know.
Hello, audience. I'm Diamond. People usually call me Dizzy. Call me Dizzy if you like. I'm a junior here at DePauw, and I am also a psychology major. But on the weekends, I'm a DJ, so you should check that out.
What kind of music?
Usually I go for like a little EDM, kind of a little bit of pop, a little hip hop, a little rap, a little everything. I never choose like a specific theme.
So, first off, why Bachelor? Why are you looking for love through D3 TV?
I don't know. I feel like it's a good way to meet somebody. Most people would frown upon it, like, oh, I don't want to go on a dating show. Who wants to go on a dating show? But who knows? You could probably meet someone really cool, and that's why I'm here. I feel like I can meet someone that I really connect with, can hang out with, someone who's really down to earth.
Okay, so down to earth is kind of the last thing you touched on.
Yeah.
What other qualities are you looking for in a bachelor?
I'm kind of looking for someone who has a sense of humor, because I like to try to be funny sometimes. So a sense of humor is kind of important. Someone I can have like an intellectual conversation with, someone's intelligent, like obviously. Someone who likes to have fun adventures, stuff like that. Like maybe, say for instance, I want to go skydiving. So you have to be down for that.
Yeah. I'm Olivia. I do pageants. I've done them since I was 4. So don't think like toddlers and tiaras or anything, because that's like, it's not intense enough, honestly. It's a big world. It's a big part of my life. But I'm kind of ready to like get out of it a little bit. I'm getting out of the spotlight a little bit, you know?
So what's the, why don't you tell us more about the pageant lifestyle? What's the biggest thing you've ever won?
Well, I won Junior Miss Teen Runner-Up, and that was, I think, 3 years ago? Yeah, so I've been doing this for a long time. I kind of know what I'm doing.
Fantastic. Glad to hear. Okay, well, then, let's move on to the Bachelor. Now, what are you looking forward to in a potential Bachelor candidate?
I really want someone who's got drive, you know, a lot of ambition like I do. But it's gonna be a deal breaker if he doesn't take care of himself. You know what I'm saying? You have to put pride into the way you look. I think growing up with pageants made me realize that. But if you really don't put yourself together, you're probably not worth my time.
That's a very fair point. You wanna find someone who has the same kind of drive and idols as you and is able to connect with you on multiple levels.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
My name is Adriana. My friends call me Llama. I'm just a confused soul in the mist of Indiana.
Okay, then. So, Do you have any hobbies as a confused soul in Indiana?
Yes, hobbies. Yeah. Well, I like to drink a lot of coffee. I'm really into the beatnik generation. I really like what they stood for. Sometimes you'll find me in the GCPA kind of wandering the halls. I like theater a lot because I like to take on different characters, but nothing is better than my own characters, so yeah. What else do? I'm an English major. You might have already picked up on that though, so. What am I looking for? Wow. That's a big question. I guess the question is, what am I not looking for? You know? Yeah. So, what I'm not looking for, I don't know, I need someone to like understand my like confused soul and kind of not really help me find myself, because, you know, whatever. But like, I don't know. Wow.
Hello, my name is Teresa Carper. I am a senior English writing major, double minor in Chinese and studio art. I am a second year contestant on The Bachelor. I had a pretty historic first season, as I like to think. And I'm back for vengeance.
Why are you back this year? Why are you still convinced that D3TV can help you find love?
Well, this is a little bit of a tender topic, actually, for me right now, because there must have been some kind of miscommunication, but I was under the impression that this was my show. So, like, this is a little bit awkward for me right now, because I thought that I was going to be the Bachelorette. Like, I thought we were doing a second show with me as a star. So, like, when I showed up today and there were, like, 11 other girls here, like, that was a little bit weird for me, because I thought I was going to be the only one. So, a little awkward.
What do you think of the other girls? You've been out there, you've been talking to them for a while, kind of getting used to all the other candidates. What do you think of this group, especially compared to last year's?
You know, a little more colorful. Got some wild personalities, it seems, but, you know, nothing I can't handle.
So, I guess we're going into the last question now. Why should the audience root for you? Why should they be nudging the Bachelor saying, hey, Teresa, she's definitely the one who's going to win your heart?
What's not to love?
All right, then.
So, I'm Jamia, and that's just it. I dance and I like to play volleyball, but I'm really into my school stuff, so I think I'm going to major in political science and then go to law school.
Fair enough. What characteristics are you looking for in a potential bachelor?
I like a sweetheart. He has to be really nice, but not too nice. Not to where I can push him over, because I will do that if I can. And really smart. I'm into really smart people. And I guess that's it. That's probably not it, but that's all I can think of.
Well, my name is Perrin Duncan, and I'm from Edmond, Oklahoma. You know, I'm just really looking forward to this season of The Bachelor, because I know that in the end, it'll be me. I really want to give everyone a fair chance, because I think everyone deserves that. But I know that in the end, it'll be me.
Well, what sets you apart from the rest of the competition? What are your kind of interests and your hobbies?
Wow. There's kind of a lot that sets me apart. I'm pretty smart, for one. I'm super involved. I really have everything going for me. I'm really good with parents, too. So I know his parents will like me, regardless.
It's always an important
part. Yeah.
So what are you looking for in a potential bachelor candidate then?
Oh gosh, someone that just really likes me, you know, because I'm pretty likable. and I think that's what's most important when I'm like looking for my husband, is someone that just almost like worships me in a way.
My name is Maria. My second home is the gym. That's all I do, day and night. If I could sleep in there, I would. I would sleep, you know, on the press, doing stuff, whatever I can. I guess you could say I have small woman syndrome. But you know what? I mean, if you can't match me in a gym, bro, like, don't date me.
Okay. So, besides a gym atmosphere, gym attitude, what are you looking for in a potential bachelor candidate?
I mean, seriously. If we can go leg day, you're it for me. We're swole mates. That's one. And if you take your macros, that's even better. You keep up with your protein, that is great. No, that's pretty much it. It's easy. Just feed me, make me laugh, lift with me.
Okay, lift with you, love you. It's great. Yeah.
Thank you, Jeremy. Yeah,
it just makes things work. So why should the audience root for you? Why is the audience going to be nudging you like, hey, you should go to the gym and spend more time with Maria. You should go pick her. She's the right candidate here.
I'm just mainly more about health, you know, offer yourself holistic growth. Be strong mentally, emotionally, physically, but it's more about what you get in the gym. It's discipline, it's consistency, and I try to reflect that in what I do, and that's what tends to happen with fitness, and that's why I really enjoy fitness and health.
Okay. I'm Megan Mullen. I'm a junior here at DePauw. I am from Phoenix, Arizona. I'm an economics major with an art history minor, and I'm just happy to be here. I want to see who the next Bachelor is.
That's awesome. I'm glad to have you. And do you have any hobbies or interests that really set you apart from the competition?
Well, I spend most of my time here studying. That's our number one reason for being here. But let's see, I love to prank people. Seems to be a specialty of mine. And I love biking on the weekends. If the weather's nice like it is today.
Megan, what would your ideal bachelor candidate be?
Well, he has to be funny. That'll go straight to the heart. And after that, I'll be love struck. And I don't think anything else will pretty much just, we'll see how it goes. I think maybe, of course, looks is a little up there in the category list. But other than that, with my studying, I would love for us to be on the same schedule of work-play balance. So that's what I'm thinking.
My name is Jess. I'm from Chicago.
What are your hobbies? Do you have anything, any particular interests, anything you do for fun that you really enjoy?
I'm really liking out with my friends. I'm a transfer, so I just got here, and I've been really enjoying school so far.
Good. So how are you liking DePauw?
I love it. It's so much fun. I love it.
What kind of characteristics are you looking for in a bachelor?
He has to be funny, easy to talk to, and just an all-around like good person. You just have to be able to have a conversation.
Okay. Why should the bachelor pick you? What's going to put you above all the rest of the competition?
I think I'm a fun person, and I have no drama, and I'm very straightforward, so I tell people how it is and what I like and what I don't like. So I think that they didn't pick me, they'd be crazy.
So that's what all your friends are going to be telling the bachelor?
Yeah, basically what they're going to be saying.
Jess is the one you should say.
Yeah, basically, okay. For sure.
Well, probably should get to the end of the interview.
Got
wrap it up a little bit. What is your ideal date?
I don't know, just going to eat and then to a movie or something. I like the nature park. Going there would be cool.
And I'm here with The Bachelor. So why don't you start off by telling us who you are and what all you're about?
Okay. My name is Tolani Verissimo. I'm a senior here at DePauw. Born and raised in Lagos, Nigeria. Live in Staten Island, New York. And I'm all about life, man. I'm all about fun. I'm all about enjoying the moment and living a good life. So anything that gets me in there.
Fantastic. Well, why don't you tell us about some of the hobbies?
Some of my hobbies. All right. Well, I like to draw. I'm not really that good. I've always liked to draw. But I guess one of my more recent hobbies is fantasy football, which is more of an addiction than a hobby at this point. But I just started, and I've been watching a lot of The League, which I don't know if you've seen.
Yeah, it's always, always.
You know, in addition to that, I'm just like, you know, I guess every other guy, like, go out, I like to have fun. Most of the times, you know, when I do stay in, it's to read a good book and surf the interwebs, and that's about it.
Very nice. Very well-rounded with your hobbies. Yeah. But let's get down to the brass tacks. What are you looking for in a potential bachelorette?
What am I looking for? It's a hard question, but I guess it's not that hard when I think about it. I think I have a type. I was talking about this with a friend the other day, and you know, looking back at it, I never really thought I had a type, but now that I think about it, I like curvy women, and that's not just, you know, in a sexualized way, that's not just physically curvy. I like, you know, a good smile. I like, you know, a good body as well, obviously. I love eyes. Hazel are my favorite color. You know, I have poop brown eyes. So, you know, I don't really get too concerned about it because, you know, it's not something I need, but I love good eyes. If I'm able to stare into somebody's eyes and get lost, that's always a great way for conversation. I can talk forever. Another thing is definitely an outgoing personality. She doesn't have to be too adventurous, you know, but as long as she's outgoing, willing to step out of her comfort zone every now and then, every once in a while, experience something that I love, or, you know, likewise, I experience something that she loves, that makes for a lot of good adventures, a lot of good memories, and a lot of good times. And like I said, I'm all about enjoying life, and if I have a companion or somebody that, you know, I can connect with and enjoy life with on a multifaceted level, even more so than I can by myself, and I'm all for that.
Okay. So hello, I'm Jeremy, and I am here with Bachelor. So why don't you tell everybody who you are and what all you're about?
Sure. Thanks a lot, Jeremy. Well, here I am. Zachary Schiller is my name. For all those who didn't know, I was at Colorado College for my first year of college, Colorado College, and I was there. I loved the people there, and things were going well. And I knew that there was something missing from my heart, so I came to DePauw University in the Midwest, the land of love, and now that I'm here, I see the love here, and it happens every day, and I'm just ready to kind of tackle my life and take it the way it needs to go.
Fantastic, really glad to hear it, and really glad to have you here.
Excellent.
But let's get right down to the brass tacks. And,
sure.
What exactly are you looking for in a potential bachelorette?
Potential bachelorette. Above all, what I'm looking for is spirit. I'm looking for that drive that gets you out of bed in the morning and that pulls you through the day. And it's invisible and it's a wavelength, and that's really what I'm looking for. And to be honest, there is no what I'm looking for. I mean, there are just so many combinations of people out there. There's not one in particular that I feel I need. So I'm just ready to experience all the different types of people that DePauw has to offer, and we can decide off that which way my heart will blow.
Very kind of poetic response to it.
Sure.
Very reflective. And why now? You're kind of seem to be wanting to take things in, take things slow, but you decided your first couple weeks on campus, now is the moment that you want to.
And you know, Jeremy, that is a very good question. I'm at a time in my life right now where love is going to be more important than ever. I mean, I'm looking back at my grades, I'm looking at everything that's going on, and just having that wingman by my side, just that wingwoman who can really just be there, and we can freaking rob banks together, just do what we need. And right now is the perfect time. I mean, we're in college, we're in the freaking Indiana. I mean, this is probably the best time we could ever have.
Okay, well thank you for the wonderful interview.
Yeah, Jeremy, thanks so much, man.
Good luck finding love in the next couple weeks, and can't wait to introduce you to all the wonderful ladies.
No,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no
Can y'all twirl around one time, just real quick? Come on.
One, you want us to do a 360?
Yeah, please.
Is this like a song there you about go. Some sexual items right now?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I feel objectified.
You
guys
are great.
You
guys
listen
on your own, but I just offered my lap. That's cool.
Yeah, I'm not sounding nice. I just don't want to get it. So, what's your name?
My name's Diamond. You can call me Dizzy if you want.
Dizzy?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Dizzy.
Nice to meet you, too.
The glasses. what is your name?
Maria.
Maria?
Yeah.
Who's that?
What
up, Sam? Thanks for a lot.
Yeah, I mean, these quads, you know, I didn't work for them for nothing. Yes. Oh my god. I'm Olivia.
Hi, Olivia. How's it going?
I'm Jess.
Jess. What's up, Jess?
I'm hearing. So if I win, am I going to have both of you?
I don't want to give away any secrets yet. So
okay.
I like the positive attitude, though. It's a lot of optimism.
Yeah, definitely. You're both really attractive, so I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, my name is Adriana, but my friends call me Llama. But
is there?
Don't call me Llama.
Is there? How did that originate?
There's no story behind it.
There's
no. No.
Nice. Oh, how do you know about them? Are you one of the friends you call?
I'm one of the friends. That's it.
Okay. Nice.
I am Teresa, like the mother. My friends call me T-Carp. There's also no story behind that.
Okay. I'm Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Jamia.
Nice to meet you.
I know.
Oh my god.
I'm Megan.
Nice to meet you. I'm Tolani. My friends call me T. My high school football coach called me Salami. Tolani Salami. You can pick whatever nickname you want. But yeah, my name is Tolani Ruiz. Nice to meet you guys.
I like that.
Salami. I'm not Salami. My name is Zach. Went by Dirty Jewels in middle school and high school. I'm a freestyle rapper. Not famous. I might spit something. No, not yet. No worries. Unless one. Can you drop a beat? One of you guys can drop it.
Okay.
Stop it.
Here we go.
All
right, let's see. Here we go. My name is Zach and this is coming back. Hey, hold up. Right on the spot, man. I'm feeling kind of hot. Look around the room, man. I'm looking at some thoughts. What? My back's actually blowing out right now.
Yes,
mind if we
it's all yours.
Kiss that! Yeah, the place don't matter!
No. Wait, so did you say you were from Texas?
Oh, no, my twin brother goes to school there. In Dallas. You're from Houston?
Identical twin?
Well, he's a boy.
Should have thought about that.
So, no, he's 6'1". People think we're dating.
Oh, wow.
That's why I decided maybe The Bachelor people would know, okay, we're not dating.
So now we've met The Bachelors. What do you ladies think?
They're awesome.
Yeah,
I'm really into it.
So what we're going to do next is we're going to split into two groups of five and give you smaller groups to kind of talk to and meet The Bachelors before the rose ceremony this evening. So it'll be a little bit more of a twist. Things will change up and we'll let you guys know when that all happens.
Great. Thank you.
All right, guys, just a little something I was wanting to do was just go in a circle and kind of get what your spirit animal was. So,
sure.
Jess? Yeah. Jess.
Mine, for sure, would probably be an orca.
Oh, my God.
I just, like...
Jess, this is not the time to start running. Why are you crying?
Like, they're just like captivity. It's just like, it's so horrible.
That is pretty horrible. If you've seen Blackfish, I think you'd understand.
Yeah,
it's a documentary. But anyways, my spirit animal is a horse because they have like no predators and no prey. They're just like a very free animal.
Okay. Would you describe yourself as free, like free roaming?
Yeah, definitely.
Actually, there's like people and like, New Mexico and Arizona have been like known to like slaughter that and like eat that and like
right. Rest
of
it. Right, but in the wild,
this
they
is
really
a,
have
this
no.
is a friendly area. And we will all do a rest of a giant whale.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, it was, like, a lot.
We'll do what we can. Thanks.
Yes.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
No, you're totally fine. No worries.
I'd say my spirit animal is probably a lion or lioness. Because they're very fierce. They're one of the top predators, and I feel like I resonate with them.
When do you get this?
What do you guys think of all of the other, I guess I don't say bachelorettes, but
actually, wait a second.
Is this for something?
Yeah, my purse is kind of tired of it. So, it's kind of tired of being on the floor.
Yeah.
And what were you saying? Other girls?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just going to just sort of, like, it's sure. Still, I'm just close to the floor.
I honestly think I'm the reincarnation of a Super Saiyan God.
Oh my God.
I don't know what else to tell you.
Wow.
So is that an animal?
It's not. It's hard to say. Like.
You're a reincarnation of
a Super Saiyan God. I mean, have you seen it?
Super Saiyan?
Super Saiyan. Super Saiyan. Have you seen the Dragon Ball Z movies?
Gohan. I know they're kind of
Exactly. Yeah. My friends call me Mystic Maria, like Mystic Gohan. Unlimited power.
Have you ever done like crazy shit like that to like a shootout? Really?
We'll talk more.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think mine's a golden retriever because they're blonde and friendly, but a little competitive.
A little competitive. Do you like to play fetch?
How'd you get to DePauw, Llama? Don't mind me calling you that.
Oh, it's fine, I guess. Well, it's sort of a complicated story. But mostly I'd like to ask, how did DePauw get to me? You know what I mean?
I think. You really got me with that one. I'm mind blown after all.
Yeah.
Do you take philosophy classes?
Yeah. I think she's just on Tumblr a lot, actually.
Oh. Or,
I feel like you guys are trying to like figure out who I am. And like, I don't know if you're gonna figure that out.
So what's your spirit animal?
Mine? Oh my God. Probably some sort of badger. If you guys can just kind of imagine a badger, I'd probably be inside that, break out, run free.
Sure. Good with woodwork, kind of.
Good with woodwork, yeah. Nice. I like metalworking as well, just like crafting tables. If you guys have ever seen, there's like decayed wood with a plaster on top, alabaster.
You can borrow my Steri pen anytime.
Oh, I'd love to.
It purifies the water in 30 seconds.
Oh, I've actually heard about those. Mm-hmm. I think those are really useful. But, you know, on that note, I think I'm going to head out, maybe go see the other girls, talk to them, you know, show them a little bit of love as well. But it's been a pleasure talking to you guys. And thank you. It was a pleasure meeting you guys as well. And I'll see you soon. I'll probably send Zach in here too, so you don't get bored just sitting around. I'll see you guys in a second. Thank you.
Bye.
Hey guys, thank you so much. Let me
enjoy
my
day. That sounds great.
It was really nice talking to
you. Yeah, I know how this feels, so that'd be good.
Excellent. That's great.
Hi, ladies.
Hi. How are you?
Not bad.
It's good to see you again.
Yeah. How's everything going?
Pretty well, yeah.
Well, yeah.
We missed you, though.
Oh, thank you. excuse me, I'm sorry. What's your name?
Olivia.
Olivia, all right, cool. No, you look nice. You're kind of quiet, though, so I have a question for you.
Okay.
What are your top three guilty pleasures?
My top three guilty pleasures? That's a good question, actually. Let's see. I watch too many shows about cupcakes.
Specifically about cupcakes?
Specifically about cupcakes. There are a lot of them. You would be surprised. Okay. I really like food more than I probably should. I like... what's my second one? Listening to musicals. Guilty pleasure.
Okay.
What about you? Do you have any?
Do you mind?
I prefer.
I actually mind.
I prefer
if you. It's legal in here.
Oh. We're kind of indoors. You smoke 27s?
I guess it looks like I do, right?
I mean, is this not your pack?
I don't know how to answer that question, so I'm not gonna answer
it. You don't need to answer it. It's fun.
What's the top one on your bucket list?
Bucket list? I don't even know. I'm obsessed with myself, so like, trying, you know, I have that mindset of sculpting my body into what I want.
Nice.
And it's just I think it's just a lifetime process. There is no bucket list.
Mm.
Yeah, it is good to have goals.
Yeah.
I think that is probably one of your goals,
to have such a great body. I mean, you're doing a really good job.
Thank you.
Yeah. Probably the top thing on my bucket list is just like live a fulfilled life and find a man that'll really like make me happy and I can make happy. So
are you dependent on someone else to make?
No, definitely not. Like as you can tell.
Do you, boo boo, do you?
Thank you.
It's okay. Were you on the show last season?
I was.
Oh, nice.
Why are you doing it again? Yeah.
Didn't that work out?
Vengeance is why I'm doing it.
Holy smokes.
Yeah, I made it to the final episode and I was gypped. I wrongfully so. But gypped.
Who
won?
She who must not be named. I mean,
she who must not be. All right, so let's not name her. That's fine.
I don't want to name names, but you know.
How about yourself? Do you have a major of choice or?
I mean, technically I do, but I'd rather spend my time just like cheering. So.
Interesting.
What would your ideal date be?
Ideal date? Oh man. My ideal date, I haven't even met the woman before, and I'd be a fireman in this date, and I bust in there, and the cat runs out, and then I jump in, and there she is. She falls into my arms. We go back. I buy her lunch, and things are okay at this point. And finally, the night comes around, and we go to some uptown, probably jazz club, and it is pumping. It's on poetry reading, and it's still creative, and it would be kind of like
that's that. My ideal date.
Crazy.
Really?
Wow. Yeah.
So I put on a suit to make this significantly more serious.
And it's worked.
Good. How do you both feel right now?
I'm all right. You could say I'm content.
Content, all right. So the votes have been cast. Zach, Talani, you need to leave. Zach, congratulations.
I'm not leaving.
But, like, you need to...
It's all right.
Okay.
Congrats, but I'll still be here, so... We go through this together. Just tie me in, okay.
Best of luck, you know. You obviously picked a lesser man, but you can figure that out on yourself.
Thank you.
And all.
Hold up. I'm not about to do this if we're wanting to match together. And we can work out together.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Peace!
Oh, bye. Bye.
Ladies and other ladies, may I present to you the DePauw Bachelor.
Who's that?
Come on, guys.
I mean, whatever. Why? Why? I don't get it. I don't get it. I'll never get it.
It's okay, boo-boo. I got you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Who needs him? Who needs him? Got my workout partner, right? That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
What they about to do without us? What if we make this show interesting?
I'm not saying we're the shit, but...
We the shit!
And you notice...
I'm excited. So, yeah, this is going to be great. Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Hold on, but where is Maria?
She went with Delaney. Yeah. So we have you.
Come on, let's start speaking.
Guys,
it's
really great to be here.
We are a team here.
Not leave alone. No, honey, I'm good. I could have another, but I probably should not.